Hey everybody, this is Charles from Tall Bulls and Balls, and I got my first litter today. And sometimes in our hobby, you watch too much social media, and I get so scared when I see everybody else having all these wonderful litters of boar babies, and I sit back and I'm like, I don't have any yet. And today, I went downstairs early this morning, and like I do almost every day, and went through RV cage, and I found a litter of babies from a snake that I really wasn't expecting to have babies, and I'm just happy that they're here. But let me give you a brief history of this female. So I've learned, I usually don't buy snakes at a snake show, first of all, and I don't buy them off of the table, especially if they're hats. But I saw this snake who a guy had named Jeff, and the snake was had great size on her, and come to find out that she was from Tom Kelly, and so it was she was supposed to be double head blood and albino, and so just so happened that I had Tom's number in my phone, and I called him right away, and I asked him where the snake was from, and he said he got the snake from Gilbert, and that of Gilbert Boas, and he has his own line of boas, that Gilbert line, and he said he had got the snake from Gilbert many years ago, and that he believed he had never bred the snake before, but he did believe that the snake was double head. So I purchased the snake at a great price off of this table, the first head that I ever have brought off of a table, and I brought it home. And I kept her around for probably last, 2 years. And I bred her for the first time. And she had babies. I bred her to a blood because I did not have a call albino het blood or a call albino blood. And so I bred her to a het hypo blood. That was beautiful hypo blood that I have. And today I received babies. And I can tell you she is het for blood. I gotta figure out a way to do. I gotta figure out a way to breed her to a snake that's het or that's albino and blood, so that we can prove out the albino side of her. But this is the fun thing about breeding, that part right there, just finding out what those snakes really have. I do have a moon glow that's het for blood that I could have bred him to her, and if I would have made a better decision, that's what I really should have done. We live and we learn. And so I'm going to show you these babies, and I hope you like them. This first one looks to be a blood that would be 50% het for albino. So this little fellow to me, I believe, is just a hypo, but it is 100% het for blood and 50% het for albino. I like to see it after it sheds though. But it looks just like a hypo to me. This right here looks to be blood, and I would say hypo by the tail. It's definitely blood, has that beautiful marking of a blood, is that black eye. So it has that black eye. Let me give you a better view of this eye. That cold black eye of a blood. And we'll wait to see after it sheds out. But it does look hypo to me by that tail. Different from the other tail, you see the spots and the roundness at the end of them. That's a dead giveaway for hypo. This one here would be a hypo blood. This beautiful one to me looks like a hypo blood. The tail is what gives it that hypo look to me. This is a hypo blood. I believe this is his here is just a hypo, which would be 100% het for blood. And I don't know if the het for blood changes the color or the pattern, but this right here is definitely a hypo that is 100% het for blood. which would be 50% het for albino. Here we have another hypo. That's 100% het for blood, 50% het albino. Let me tell you something. These little babies like to run like little noodles. This is another little blood that is 50% het albino. I don't know about the hypo. And I might be wrong on a lot of these. I'll wait for them to shed out and then I can really, you know, the hypo is gonna enhance that red. It's gonna be brighter. So we're gonna wait for them. So if I said hypo, it just might not be. I could be wrong, we'll see. But this one looks just blood to me. What do you think? Look at that tail. Beautiful blood it is. Here we have another hypo. Hundred percent het for blood. I really like the tail on this hypo. It's nice. We have another hypo. Hundred percent het blood. This is another hypo, I believe. Really pretty. I love the tail. Nice. This is a hypo. Beautiful tail. 100% het for blood. Here you go. I don't know if it's normal or if it's hypo. I think it's a normal. That would be 100% het blood and 50% het albino. And I believe this last one, which is number 12, is also a normal. There would be 100% het blood and possibly het albino.